national, regional, and international requirements to develop the study plans based on market needs. I'm Dr. Abdulrahman Qawasmi from Majma'a University. The contents: development of the study plans, national requirements, regional requirements, international requirements, and development of study plans based on market needs. Development of the study plans, the readiness of the feedback based on the implementations of the academic program, which means you need to prepare all the reports and stakeholders' feedback, and also reports from internal and external reviewing committees with recommendations in order to be ready to develop your study plan. Also, you should have a good operational plan for curriculum development, and also you have to follow regulations, guides, and procedures in preparing the new or the developed study plan, and it should be include following standards, frameworks, and quality issues. Regarding the national requirements, we have Vision 2030, and you have to look at some visions aspects, for example, like sustainability, decreasing the gap between the academia and the market by increasing the practical issues in your curriculum, also teaching and learning improvement. Also, you have to follow the NCAAA requirements or standards regarding the graduate attributes, national qualification framework, curriculum design and learning outcome domains like knowledge, understanding, skills, and values. Also, one of the national requirements is QIAS standard exam. Qudurat for bachelor stage, you have to know what are the requirements of QIAS standard exam and to follow in updating your curriculum. And finally, the Saudi Council of Engineers. Regarding the regional requirements, you have to follow the Gulf Cooperation Council regarding agreements and engineering education, also the Association of Arab Universities, which founded in 1964. This will help in transfer students and legalization of certificates. About international requirements, as you know, for engineers, we have international accreditation, ABET, and also we can use the international universities as benchmarking, and also we can follow the new trends and innovation in engineering. And finally, the postgraduate studies will be more easy for our students if we are following the international requirements. Finally, develop the study plans based on market needs. We have to analyze the feedback from employers and advisory board, alumni, and of course the Saudi University benchmarking. And finally, Ministry of Human Resources and Social Development. And also you have to consider the Saudi standard classification of occupations.